Well, you certainly don't have to go far to have a good time. A trip to Roger Williams Park Zoo is always a day full of fun for the whole family, mm-hmm. and it's back open.
Yeah.
But there's a lot that goes on that you never see to keep the animals happy and healthy. For example, did you know their whole food system rivals that of any top restaurant? Mm. I had a chance to check out their brand new commissary building. A change you may not see
and think of yogurt
has upgraded the daily lives of the animals at the zoo.
The animals have to eat, obviously, and they eat a great diet, but it's really important that they have a full service kitchen to prepare, because we have such varied diets, everything from hay for the elephants, fish for the seals, produce for the monkeys. So we really need a full service commissary to take care of all the animals here at the zoo. And it's a great building. It's like everything else at the zoo. We try to make it energy efficient as well as just very usable for all of our staff. And this just does the animals. We have separate kitchens for the people, of course.
And just like people, all the animals have specific needs that need to be tracked and logged every day.
The veterinary's department will come up with the diets. They'll figure out all the nutritional needs of the animals, the calories, all the interesting things. Then they will send it out and we'll make up the diets. From there, the keepers will say, animal didn't really care for this item. Can we try something else? So we adjust a couple times to get it all figured out.
We got a tour of the brand new state-of-the-art facility, including some unusual locations.
So Tom, where are we now?
This is our hay storage area. We have a big room that we have hay and shavings. The nice thing about the new room we have here is it's big. And so we were able to get in bigger loads less often of the supplies we need. So where in the past we'd get 250 to 300 bags of shavings at a time, we can now get up to a semi-load, which is like 12 or 1300. It's still a new process, so we're trying to figure out exactly how much we can hold and how much it'll work for everybody. But yeah, the first time we put 500 bales of hay in here, it was kind of cool.
Our next stop takes us upstairs.
This is the grain storage room. We have over 40 different types of grain for the animals, depending on their needs. So we're good for monkeys and chickens and rabbits and pigs and horses and hoofstock and giraffe and elephants and anything we have here at the zoo. And so we actually have four different types of primate grain, because there's specific needs for some of the animals. Some of the grains will go for different animals, some of them are specifically for one type. So as needed, we're pretty much good to go with most of the things that we need up here.
These bags look heavy. How do you get them out of here?
One of the nice things they did when they built this building is they put in a dumbwaiter to take the bags from upstairs to downstairs. Shut the door. And down it goes.
Tell me what's going on here.
We're making diets for some of the animals. We're going to start with the babirusa. The screen will come up and just tell us what to give the animals that day. And it will change from day to day. That way they don't get the same thing every day. Babirusa, we're going to give them half a cup of peanuts. We're going to cheat a little bit, give them a little extra. We usually don't
do this. Special occasion.
Since you're here.
Yes.
And so that's, you know, about half a cup. Now that it's all done, we put them in the bins. That way they can go out into the actual areas for the animals. Now this one goes in here and this one goes over here. That way they will just head out to where they belong.
Tom says he loves the job because he knows it's making an impact for the animals.
You get to see a difference in the animals because of what we do. If the keepers come and they say the animals are doing good, they like what we're doing, that's a good thing.
And don't forget, even while the zoo was closed to the public, the zookeepers were still there every day taking care of the animals, and this brand new building has been able to make them even more efficient. The zoo is back open now. Head to roadshow.com for more info on their hours.